This is Sinjar, the dust 2 of Insurgency. The map that everybody says they hate, but when the map world comes, nothing else gets any votes. And I'm Ukko, and I'm gonna teach you how not to get completely utterly destroyed on Sinjar Bush. Right then, let's keep this short and simple. Do not go up this hill. This is what I call the noob hill, where everyone just gets slaughtered. It's like, why would you even go there? Why would you go there? Okay, so the only actual way to get anything done is to go up the mid. You're gonna go up here as soon as the round starts, okay? Go from here. Check this position usually has someone in it, okay? Go from here. I don't recommend going up the stairs there. It's safer to go from here. Okay, now at the start of the round, you need to try catch if someone is going to this position here, okay? It's like get rid of him. Same thing, sometimes some of them try to come down here. Be aware of that. Smoke here. Wait a second. And now that you've gone up here, the point of going here is to help, of course, the attack. Clear out all the enemies. Watch out. It's very rare, but there's sometimes someone watching this position, okay? Might be there. This is covered and littered with machine guns and snipers, usually. Hi there. Okay, there's snipers here, everywhere, up the hill. Just check all the positions. You can go. Then you can go, of course, back to the side down here. You can shoot the enemies from up there, too. Usually it's better to have, actually, a few dudes up at their spot. Up at their spawn, sorting out the wankers, and the other team is just capping the point. So, to recap, some of the team goes to the site, and some of the team go to the enemy spawn to cut off the reinforcements.
We just taken Alpha.
Right then, for Bravo, be advised, there's always a capper in the building right in front of the spawn. So, what you wanna do is go for right flank. All the way down here. You can go even from here. Now, you don't have to come all the way down here, you can kind of trick your way around there, but it's... guess it's the safest way to go down here. It's very rarely, sometimes some noob is camping that building, but it's very rare.
Hey, you don't have orders to be there.
Don't be worried about that. You can go there, you just can't use your gun. Right? Are you here?
Are we safe? We're not authorized there. Turn around.
Move like a noob.
Stop it. Turn around. Tutorials.
Alright. This is, of course, very, very, very dangerous place to be. Don't go right in here from the open. You can go from there or something. Basically, just look around, you see enemies, kill them. And that's their spawn. You can go here, stay here. Boop, when they come around. Just kind of go to the objective.
We're taking Bravo now!
This is the best spot, honestly, to cap the place. Like, people can shoot the RPG there. You're most likely not gonna die, they can shoot down, so blah blah blah. Most people don't even realize this spot is in here. Just sit here and wait when they come up the stairs and pop.
Bravo is clear, we got it.
Always remember, try to get to the next objective as soon as the previous one is captured, right? Sometimes people there. She is a bit of a pain in the ass, it's got two stories and million camp spots. Just Get nades. Honestly, get nades. There's people behind, there's coming from here. Now, you might wanna block this bridge off with a incendiary grenade or something.
Charlie, guys.
I have a bunch of guys shooting the noobs when they come from the spawn. This is a bit of a trick spot, people don't realize this, even though it, you know, to a person with brains, it kind of, like...
Yeah,
just take a quick tour around here. This is, of course, a good spot. You can go here. Mess around a little bit here. Okay, so if you didn't get to see as soon as P was capped,
You can once again utilize this area here. It's really a kind of a universal flank. It works almost on all sides going around here. Like, yeah, there might be someone looking at the area, but it's like it's super open and everything, so nades work very well here. And you can usually flank from here. So you can still use it. Go from all the way from B spawn down here to C. I mean, usually people don't expect you to come from here, so you can just kind of, you know, their spawn, C-side, you can block them from coming in, stuff like that. And last for D, you don't actually have to go anywhere near it, you can just kind of lob nades at it. Aim for the vaulting there. I'll make a separate video about all the ways you can destroy weapon caches, but you should just do it for now. It doesn't blow out, just get more nades. Now don't be afraid to go back to your spawn to get some more nades to resupply, you know? Boom! There we go. To cover as much of this as possible, we go now look at some of the most common camping spots for the defenders that you need to be advised for. Right here, up this hill. There's usually a guy here looking down there. That's why you don't go down that hill. There's people here. Here. Just everywhere here. If you go put nades somewhere, put them here, right? One thing people don't usually realize that you can gap and block the gap from back of this truck. Right? Just go prone there, no one's gonna find you. One other tricky spot that people usually forget to look at when people are gapping, if you gap here. Strangely, it doesn't look exactly safe, but that's what people miss a lot of times. Remember, you cannot gap inside this building. I don't know why, but you can. And of course, as I said, this hill is absolutely littered with enemies. Now, there's usually some tricky wanker sitting up here. So this position, this here, look, there, enemies. And sometimes at the Humvee here. Now, also remember, this is the line for the restricted area of for the defending team. So they can come all the way down here. And for B-side, the restricted area is like this. So people can be here and here and here and here and here and everywhere. Now, usually also, while the B-side conflict is going on, there's enemies defending snipers on this bridge. Okay? Be advised of that. For C. Okay, for C-side, be advised, people can actually be down here. They can actually be here. One of the more common spots, of course, people get to B. Defenders are still at B sometimes, so it's... This is this building here. There's the spawn. And this building, it usually has a lot of people. Just put an 84 up in it or something. This building has people in it. And the death corridor. This always has a bunch of insurgents down here. Probably just laying down here, looking down there. So you wanna go here and throw grenades from here to the window. Boom. Of course, be aware of your surroundings. Right here. Hook the grenade a little bit, like this. Boom. That should sort out some people. And you might wanna bounce off a nade up there. So I can get out that. Okay. Look here. Usually enemies there. Here, mm-hmm. Enemies. Oh, and this is the nasty spot. There's always enemy camping there, of course. So you might wanna... smokes. Yeah. Whatever, smoke that spot. Go up here. Take a look around. Get in. Shoot the noobs. Of course, yeah, blocking off people from coming in is brilliant. I don't know why people don't do that. So even if it's not perfect, it's gonna slow people down, okay?
We just secured Charlie.
There's one.
Don't let up! We found their cache!
Right then, that should be most of this stuff covered. Leave a like if this video helped you in any way. And consider subscribing, I'll make a few more of these tutorials. And that should be it. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.